فرص.
Now, is there a specific plan for what types of food you all are eating before you go on a flight or after a flight or the food you eat?
The idea of breakfast in the Air Force is basically called a pre-flight meal. We get a special ration for that to ensure that your mental ability is not degraded. It ensures that your G-tolerance remains what it's supposed to be. Because in an empty stomach, your G-tolerance reduces.
So what are some of the attributes that you think are important to be a Su-30 pilot?
Attitude.
That good attitude or bad attitude?
Good attitude.
Bad attitude.
Bad attitude. I saw a board up there that said aggression or aggressiveness. So do the two of you fly together or?
Yeah, we've flown together.
You've flown together. But do you have the same buddy throughout as you're flying or do you keep changing?
We keep changing. We don't have a single constant buddy, so
right.
Keep changing. It's good to fly with everybody.
So is it more like a pilot and a navigator or is it just both can do whatever they want?
No, it's a team.
Okay.
So it's a pilot and a weapon system operator.
Hmm.
The roles are very clearly defined.
This is truly, it's a great responsibility that's been put on you guys. How do you sort of have a sense of what it really is to fly one of these machines for your country?
Yes, but what really lets us do that is the kind of training that we've gone through.
Hmm.
The fact that we are fighter pilots means that I trust Dusty with my life. He trusts me with his, and this is blind faith. There are no two ways about it. It doesn't matter whether you have 30 years of service or 10 years of service or like Dusty 4 years of service. It just doesn't matter.
Coming from a 26-year-old, I'm very impressed, Abhinandan. I think I'm going to take another helping of sausage just for that, but well said, dear. These are some of the insights that most of us who are on the outside forget. This is what the armed services is all about. It's a team.